All right, this is the NBA weekend. Contenders hoops, triple team tiered. Good luck. Let's find some monsters. This song totally reminds me of summertime. It's like June. It's hot outside. Playoffs are on. Playoffs? You kidding me? All right, here we go. Looks like the Mavs are in spot number 9. Good luck. Mavericks are in number 9. Here we go. Spot 9 Mavericks. That's what you want. Martin Clark. Hold up. Wait a minute. Dew breaks every day. That was from a main man, Philly Scorpio in Philadelphia. Also known as a long distance dedication from Carter in Kansas City to Scorpio in Philadelphia. He loves that song, so there you go, Scorp. WPHL, Philadelphia. Top tenors, Neil with the Suns, Nate with the Hawks. That's good, Nate. You want Trey Young is who you're looking for in that Hawks break. Nate. Carter, you got the Knicks. Nate, you got the Bulls. Your Bulls. Tyson with the Magic and the Celtics. Neil, you got the Cavaliers. Carter with the Kings. Martin with the Mavs. And Anderson, you do have the Bucks. You can get some Greek Freak action going on. Someone else on the Bucks is good, too. Marvin Bagley Jr., maybe? And then there's the rest of your teams there. And I don't have my scroll thing set up, and I don't feel like messing with it. So, I'll print the sheet and show it. Da-na-na-na-na. Whoa, I lost everybody in chat. They're like, basketball? I'm out of here. Hold up. Wait. I'm going to hide those three boxes so nobody says, let's do those. I'm calling it a night. I'm going to go up and eat some cheese. Heather went shopping today. I got fresh cheese. Got my pretzels. Tyson, did you find out any more information about our podcast or radio station? Find us a radio station where we can just play whatever the heck we want without royalty problems. doesn't exist because I already looked. Me and Tyson are going to do a podcast. Me and Ed are going to do a wrestling podcast. We're jumping on the podcast bandwagon about 2 years too late. Let's just get, I mean, I'm telling you guys, straggler contenders sitting around here for 3 weeks. I think the reason I saved it is because I got it confused with the football. Somebody won one in the Super Bowl, and I was thinking, oh, I got to save this for a Super Bowl winner. But that was football. Come on, we've just talked about it not even 24 hours ago. You don't have all the answers yet? What's wrong with you? You know, I like the name Tyson's Corner. It just has a nice ring to it. I think there's a Tyson's Corner in Virginia or something. This. Oh my God, my heart just really took a dump. I thought that was Luca. I just saw the blue. Cracked ice, Jerome Robinson, rookie ticket for the Clippers. It's got to be good. He's a rookie. The Clippers are owned by Nate Anderson. Oh, sweet. Dude. Tyson's Corner, Virginia. Yeah. Man. That's a good-ass hit, Anderson, isn't it, Tyson? Anderson! Told you there was going to be something in this final straggler crack box that I was going to open for myself this weekend, but I sold it to you guys. Nice hit. Basically, any cracked ice rookies are good. There's a 25. For the Warriors. I knew this box was going to be good. I just knew it. These things are the worst to put in. Did Anderson even see his hit? He might be on delay or something. Number to 199, Tyreek Evans. Hold up. Jared Allen. Okay, good. Good, Anderson. Yeah, you told me to tell you you wanted to be excited. You should be excited about that cracked ice hit. What are Luca Cracked Ices selling at now? $3,000? Javon Carter, he is a Memphis Grizzly. That'll be going to you, Tyson's Corner, Virginia. Hold up. Hey. Keep rocking till the wheels fall off. Guys, know what I always say.
Boom goes the dynamite. Boom goes the dynamite. And boom goes the dynamite. Boom goes the dynamite.
Oz, what's new in Oz? Are you still watching Oz in Australia? Heard you say you went to trade night tonight, like to one of your local card shops. We're going to have trade night at Fat Cat Cards one of these nights. Donovan Mitchell. James Harden is good, to say the least, right? All right, so there was a cracked ice in it. I had a feeling like the black eyed peas, so that's good. And now let us find out what's in this mighty NBA hoops that's been here since release night 2 months ago. Two autos coming out of here. Mo Bamba. Tyson, is Steve looking to buy anything? Does he want to buy any plates and patches football? Keep rocking till the wheels fall off. Hold up. Yeah, because if he doesn't want to buy them, I'm going to end up selling them to the Evil Empire. So check with him. I'd rather sell them to him. I know he does pretty good with the football there. Right, tell me what he's buying them for. Number to 2018, Chris Paul. If it works better for him, if he needs some time, that's fine too. Number to 99, Taron Prince. Green shiny thing. He is a Atlanta Hawk. That's Anderson. Anderson. Well, to answer my question earlier that nobody answered, Anderson was also Mr. Kennedy in wrestling. He was Mr. Kennedy in WWE, I think, and he was Anderson. No, he was Anderson in TNA and Mr. Kennedy in WWE, or do I have it backwards, Ed, if you're still listening? Ed's probably playing Madden. He's probably checking out the forums, looking at 101s on Facebook, playing Madden, selling stuff on eBay. DJ Jr., 199 for the Mavs. Come on, Martin. RHJ Pink. I love hoops. Yes, I do. Tyson, $50 a box. Take all this hoops and Donruss I have left over. That's a deal. Kennedy Auto Grammy. Grammy, I'm going to open up your stuff tomorrow with the boys. I just don't like to open it unless I'm able to sit there with them and look through it and go through it. I just don't want to rip it open and be like, here you go. Because they're like, oh, cool, thanks. And then they'll just run away. I like them to, I'm trying to teach them how to think of others, that you take the time to send that to them versus just like open it up and be like, here you go, guys. Like, I like to explain to them that it takes time for you to put all this together and money to send it, and let's go through it together and see what it is and then tell you thank you and all that stuff. Some rookie ink of Chandler Hutchinson for the Bulls. The Chicago Bulls, to be exact. Crappy-ass Chicago Bulls. I'm going to do some EBW Select PYT. I just know what's going to happen because it's such a higher priced product. I don't want to wait till Wednesday to have all those teams left. So I'm going to just EBW the crap out of them using the Giants and the Ravens. I gave you guys enough time to buy the teams. You've had a few days to buy the dope teams. If you didn't buy them yet, I'm going to use them in a filler. Oh, cool, Grammy. Yeah, that's right. That's the, you signed your balls and sent them to us that you got at a baseball game, that is. Grammy sent some signed balls. Our second auto is a net. It's LeVert's boy. They were a big band in the 80s. Gerald LeVert's son. I don't think it's Gerald LeVert's son for real. Maybe it is. That's for you, Martin. Martin, if you're listening, I'm going to create and generate a new code for you from the other day and tonight. Shiny magic. Oh, man. Take the hoops. I'm going to do what Panini does to me. I'll give you one chance. I'll tell you exactly what I have left of each. Because if not, I'll do $7.99 triple teamers and get $80 a box. Number to 2018, Draymond Green. Denzel Valentine. All right, last of the night, last break of the night. Thanks everybody for coming in tonight. A whopping five of us left here as we shut it down. Tyson, and whoever's listening. What if every night in chat was like it was for Transcendent Night? God, that must be so awesome. That was so much fun, Transcendent Night, dude. I thought about doing that for a long time. Not necessarily Transcendent, but like a big night for big product release. The Nets again. Ooh, Otis Birdsong. Cool. Is that you? We just had a net. Martin? I remember me some Otis Birdsong, dude. Funny. Otis, unfortunately, does not appear to be a paralleled numbered card. Actually, Tyson, I'm running a campaign I'm working on called TSB Gives You More, and it's going to say exactly that. More breaks, more variety, more hits, something like that. But my newest social media campaign is going to be titled around more. More breaks, more options, more fun, something like that. I haven't narrowed it down, but that's what it's going to be. I'm going to spend a lot of money on Google and get it out there. I mean, that's how I find guys, all these new guys coming in here lately. It's because I've been running more campaigns with social media and Google and Facebook. Definitely makes a difference. There's no doubt. And you know my philosophy in business. He who has the best marketing wins. You just got to stay in the public consciousness. And it works. Unless, of course, you have Facebook groups with 5,000 people in it. Then you don't have to do a damn thing. But if you want to do this on the level I want to, and you want to attract someday potential investors and big money that's going to come into this hobby. More me. Is that the Joker from Batman? That sounds like a quote from Batman. Another shiny magic. If you can have a good product and you stay in the public's conscious, top of mind, they always see you, they're always talking about you, you're going to do fine. Yo, what up, Dieterly? Where does he get those wonderful toys? I happened to cross the Dark Knight last week, channel surfing. It was just starting, the opening scene at the bank. And then I switched it up, and I think I watched Jaws. Jaws is the movie that I probably... This will be a good topic of our podcast, Tyson, for me and you. What movie, not necessarily your favorite movie of all time, but what movie have you seen the most? You know what I mean? Like, I love Star Wars, no doubt. I'm a Star Wars guy. Everyone knows that about me. That's my jam. But it's not necessarily the movie that I've seen the most, you know? The movie that I've seen the most is Jaws. And it's not necessarily my number one overall favorite movie of all time, but it's just one that I happen to see the most for some reason. Like, I know that pretty much verbatim. One of those movies, you know the dialogue throughout the whole movie. You can quote the movie throughout. Best Batman actors. Oh, definitely I go with Michael Keaton. Ocean's 11, seriously? That's your verbatim movie? What's your verbatim movie, Robert? $1.99, Royce. My verbatim movies are Glengarry Glen Ross, Jaws, and Breakfast Club. Like, I could probably overdub Breakfast Club. You could put Breakfast Club on mute, and I could probably, just by watching the scenes, do the audio for it, pretty much. It's been a long time since I've watched it, but that would come right back to me. Yeah, I can't. My phone's dead anyway, Grammy. I'll look at it when I recharge. Clue? Ferris Bueller. It's a nuts kind of night. Martin just stole the entire dual boxes of hoops, I think, except for the Bulls. There's a Musa hot rookie cigs. Man, just think, Tyson. $50 for a box of these. You get two autos. That sounds like a deal to me. Van Wilder. Number to 2018, that would be John Wall. There's a Luka for the Mavs owner. I mean, these freaking Lukas are so daggone flipping rare. Even the commons. Let's just do a case break of hoops.